Welcome, welcome to the show. It is me, your girl Laborly, aka Cat Lee, and
I have now tuned in to Ambitiously the Podcast.
Yes, you have. Yes, you have. Listen, baby, we got a lot to talk about today. A lot. Some funny shit, some serious shit. All together, we have some things to talk about today. But what you need to know is this. Today is Media Monday. Today is the day that we discuss all of the trending topics, the latest gossip, the important news and current events. We discuss it all. You know, we'd like to chop it up and get into some of everything. So, you know, sit back and listen to what we got going on today, I guess, honey. Listen, because we got a lot to talk about, baby. Yes, we do. First things first. Phone line is always open. The number is 443-850-4828. Again, the number is 443-850-4828. If you try to call this number outside of this show, you will not get through because I do not answer it other than during the show. I just don't. It's just not in me to do. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe to this podcast. We need every like, every share, subscription. Especially, well, YouTube is free to subscribe, but you know, Patreon, become a member, and my other situations are all memberships, but it's the best way to do it because you get all of the intel that everybody else does not get when you subscribe to those avenues. But it's free to subscribe on Facebook, on YouTube, so, and it's free to like on Facebook and everywhere else, so just make sure you do that. Before I get into it, you already know what I have to do, baby. I gotta pay these bills. I'll be right back.
Want last minute brand design help? Get top-tier Fiverr freelance creatives at your fingertips, fast, with secure payments and 24/7 support. Head to Fiverr.com today and get something started.
I'm just saying, when you need help, because you can't do it all. I keep telling people that, but they never listen. But sometimes you need a little extra help. In Fiverr, you can find help. I've used them on several occasions. I've used them for a lot of other things that, you know, I wasn't privy to. Now I am, but back then I wasn't. I've used them for voiceovers for this show too. I'm probably going to use them again. I don't know. But the point is, Fiverr is a great place to start if you do not know what you're doing in certain aspects and avenues. So yeah, check them out. So as you notice, around us, we have a different background. We're trying out some things over here because we changed our logo. Yes, we did. It's a better logo, prettier logo. I think I'm going to continue with my graphic design work on that, but for the time being, in the background is our logo. Let me see something. Let me see what I could do real quick so I can really show you. Oh, no, I can't. Oh, yes, I can. Hold on one second. I'm going to show you. I'm still here, though. I'm just going to show you what it is. Oh, no, that's not the one. Let me see. I'm looking. Yep, there you go. See, we changed our logo. And so that's what's in the background now. Bring myself back on screen. That's what's in the background now. For the moment, until I decide otherwise. So we got much to talk about. So I want you, if you're listening, to close your eyes because you've probably heard about this already. If you are watching, I know you don't want to close your eyes, but close your eyes and just listen to this. Imagine this. You're on a plane and you're flying across the airways and all of a sudden the emergency door is open. Yep, that happened in Korea. That happened. So let me get into it. So according to officials, a passenger in South Korea caused air to rush into the cabin by opening an emergency exit door during the flight. This resulted in slight injuries of some of the passengers. The incident took place on an Asian Airlines Airbus A321 aircraft traveling from, I'm probably going to say this wrong, but I'm going to try, Jeju to Daeju. Despite the disturbance, the plane landed safely and video shared, and I'm going to show this video in a second. A video was shared on social media, shows passengers holding on to their armrests as their hair is blown by the air, entering the cabin throughout an open door. Now, I'm going to put this on screen, but before I put this on screen, is my boo in here? Hi, honey. Oh, what's up? Anyway, I got to put this on the screen, but before I put this on the screen, let me throw this up here real quick. And one of these days I'm explaining this, but let me throw this up here real quick. This is for educational purpose. I am informing the people about what's going on. It really never works, but I'm just going to put it up there anyway. Okay, so the disclaimer went up on the screen, and I probably showed it a couple more times throughout the evening, but I've had this here forever, and it still doesn't work. But check this footage out. Hold on. First of all, No. It's already, hold on, let me get to the right one. It's already a scary thing. Well, for some people, I actually like flying. I like being on planes. But this right here is a scary thought to me. Like, sir, what were you thinking? Why would you do that? I don't understand it. It baffles me just a little bit. Like, you're not scared. Now, I forgot what he said. The reason why he did it was like he needed some air, some bull crap like that. I don't know. But it's like, you're not afraid that once you open that door, that all hell's going to break loose. The plane might crash. People might fly off. People were injured. But just the thought, you never thought that people could fly off the plane and then lives could be lost. Maybe it was intentional. Maybe he did that on purpose. I don't know. But like I said, it's not something that I want to all the way imagine happening when I'm on the air. And I like flying. That's the crazy part. I haven't flown out of the country yet, but I've flown a lot of places in this country. And that's the last thing I want to think about happening to me. Wait. Remember that lady that died when a plane window broke? She got her head stuck out. Oh my God, sucked out and suffocated. See, that's what I'm saying. Like, okay. And that was like some freak accident type of situation. This dude literally opened it on purpose. And that's what I'm saying. That scares me. That type of stuff scares me. I don't know. You can't give people a psychological test them before they get on a plane, because then you're biased and it's just crazy. I don't know. But that happened. So I'm going to get into this other story because I found it kind of funny a little bit. All right, so let me get to it real quick. Hold on. And then I'm going to show you the footage as well. So I'm going to have to throw that disclaimer back on there. But I'm going to show you the footage also. Mm-hmm. Because it's funny. But let me read to you what happened first before I show you the footage. Okay. So, a beauty queen's husband is breaking souls and crowns at a Brazilian pageant after becoming infuriated with the chosen winner. Dude. So, in my mind, in Brazil, they take this kind of thing very serious. They don't play about beauty pageants. I'm trying to get to the footage so I can show it to you guys. Hold on. The screen is bogus. But anyway, so the NY Post, the incident occurred on Saturday at the Miss Gamato Grasso 2023 pageant in Brazil. Nathalie Becker placed second, and her husband, who remains unidentified, went ballistic. He races to the stage, then snatches the winner's crown. her name is Emanuele Bolini, and slammed it on the ground. But he wasn't finished, as he picked it up again to smash it to pieces. As Beyonce's "Break My Soul" classically plays in the background, he attempted to usher his wife off the stage until security intervened. Pageant coordinator Malone, I'm not even going to play with his last name, but the pageant coordinator released a statement addressing the judgment and the crowning a victor. We condemn the incident that occurred at the time of the crowning of the elected Miss. She stated, "We confirmed that the pageant jury's choice, and they sympathize with the elected Miss as well as Becker, as she is not responsible for the crazy attitudes of the third party, which is her husband." Yeah, it is crazy. Let me see if I could get this on the screen really quickly. Let me see what I could do real quick, because I need you guys to see this shit. It's crazy. I did not know that people took, okay, we back where we need to be, took pageantry that serious. Well, I got it's another country, so I suppose, hold on, baby, I'm gonna read your comment. Okay, yeah, we can get it on the screen now. I suppose when it comes to wait, see, and he was gonna make me laugh. I like when you come on here and do that though, because it's funny. But disclaimer, copyright disclaimer, I am just educating you guys on what happened exactly. Now, let me show you this footage really, really quickly. Yo did say that though. He said, "Not today, Lord." Not today, hold on. So let me put this on the screen really quickly so you can see what happened. Mm-hmm. I need you to see what happened. So, let me see if I can make this bigger. As you can see, the husband is going ham. Nope, can't do it that way. Hold on. I just want it to be bigger. Let me see if I could just put it this. Nope. Oh my gosh, I messed it up. Hold on, let me see what's going on. I gotta make this smaller. That's why. It was ridiculous. Hold on, y'all. I got y'all. As you can see, the husband did not look at him. He did not appreciate his boo not winning. And it's not like she came in last. It's not like Big Mac, he said, "Oh, my chick bad." It's not like she came in last. She came in second place, and this is what he decides to do. He was not here for it, but at least she didn't suffer any penalties because of his behavior. At least they understood that he was crazy and not she. But yeah, that's what happened. So yeah. The craziness of it all, that's what happened. So that happened. I don't know. I don't I don't I did not know that they took this pageantry thing that serious in Brazil. And some of my, I got listeners in Brazil. Y'all reach out to me and tell me if you speak English, because I don't speak the language. But if you speak English, yeah, reach out to me and let me know. Is this a, like, y'all take them, do y'all take these pageants that serious out there in Brazil? Because I never would have thought. I never. But he was mad. He was big mad. Okay, so I want to get into this other situation. I'm trying to see. Well, I guess I could pull up the footage and talk about it. So, let's get into it. Let's get into it, baby. So that happened. Brazil, big love to you. Don't think that I'm trying to, you know, make jokes about y'all. I'm just making jokes about the gentleman who lost his shit because his wife did not win. That's all I'm saying. It's like, dude, there's always other pageants. She can always try again. Well, yeah, I guess I understand that part too, because the older you get, okay, here we go. The older you get, the less likelihood you have of women winning certain pageants. Hold on, let me see. We got some more comments. Okay, wait a minute. Let's see. Nah, that's his woman, and he put that lady first. Didn't Tank sing that? No, that wasn't Tank that sung that. That was Jaheim. but I get it. But okay, well, I don't speak Portuguese, so we already know what that is. I want them to speak to me in English because I don't. Well, I could probably Google Translate. I don't know. Hello. Hi. Thank you for tuning in. But yeah, the point is. Oh no, here you go. Oh shit. He don't want to have the second baddest baddie in Brazil. He doesn't, but he has to get over it. She is the second place winner. She is not the first place. And then how dare he break her? I wish somebody would try to break my crown. I wish. We fighting. On real time. We fighting. Don't touch my crown. He lucky that chick that he snatched the crown from was not me. Because he told, because he totally would have got. And I always love a time to use this. Don't touch my crown. Don't touch a girl's crown. How dare you? How dare you? Don't you ever touch my crown, sir. I probably would have tried to cut him. But anyway, let's keep it moving. Because I got more to talk about. So, if you don't know by now, Atlanta is in an uproar because this happened. And I'm glad I can leave that on it because I have no use for the other panel. A former Atlanta police officer wore his uniform to serve as an lookout during the bank roll Friday robbery. Now, I reported this a while back. Hold on, babe. Let me stop right here because I got to read your comment. As a man, our egos can be fragile. My woman better win or I'ma act an ass. Sometimes you guys, listen, I'm a woman, I'm a worldly woman, right? I've dealt with all types of people. I've dealt with diplomats. I've dealt with, believe it or not, I've dealt with people in the commission as far as the state is concerned, and they are wow. But there is a certain, and I've taken courses in etiquette, right? Because I wanted to open a finishing school, a school for debutantes to show, you know, young black women that there's more out here than becoming a baby mama. Although eventually I did become a baby mama, but I got married, divorced, and then I became a baby mama. I don't know how that happened. But I do know how to conduct myself in formal settings and in informal settings. And there comes a time, whether you want to win or not, you do have to display a certain amount of decorum. You can't go out here just because you lost out here acting a fool. You can't. You just gotta move on. And if you can't enter that pageant, there are pageants for older ladies as well. It, from my understanding, that was the Miss. Now you move from the Miss and then you take your ass over to the Misses. And that's how you do that. But you can't be out here just acting a fool. And you can't almost enter a lady snatching her crown. I'm sorry, you just can't do it. But anyway, let's get back to this former police officer from Atlanta PD. So anyway, the robbery of Bankroll Freddy may be facing the rapper Bankroll Freddy may be facing his own legal challenges, but he has received some justice for a robbery that he was a victim in. On Monday, former Atlanta PD, former Atlanta PD officer Justin McCall Thorne was hit with a 10-year sentence after pleading guilty to his role in the robbery of the Arkansas rapper. The incident took place on October the 17th, 2019, which I did already report this story. I want to read your comment. Let me give one second. Let me do this. So the incident took place October 17th in 2019 at a Comfort Inn in Suites in Cobb County. Thorne served as a lookout wearing his APD uniform, gun, and badge as two other men robbed Freddie and his cousin at gunpoint. Just 2 weeks before the scheme, Thorne resigned from the department after an internal investigation was launched into his alleged taking money from a suspect to make an outstanding warrant disappear. Back in 2019, Thorne's attorney, Lenny Franco, told a bond hearing judge that his client only participated in the robbery after his family was threatened, though it's unclear by who. The fate of the others involved in the heist remains unknown. Ironically, hours before the theft, Freddie joked with the hotel staff about potentially becoming a robbery victim. Now, I'm going to be real with you in that footage because I saw that. Is the footage here? Hold on, let me say something. Let me see if I can pull that footage. Yep, it sure is. Hold on, I'm about to put that on the screen real quick. I wanted to make sure that the footage was there, honey, before I threw it on the screen. Okay. Yeah. No, we're not going to skip over that. We're not skipping over this one. No, if Kat say get him, I got him. Listen, I wouldn't tell you to get him. I would tell you, chill, babe. We got him next time. And we got him. We got him. Don't worry about all that. But let me throw this disclaimer back on the screen. Educational purposes. We are here to educate you about what is going on in the world. That's what we do over here. Babe, chill. Chill, we got him. We gonna get him in another way, but not that way. Not on the stage. Decorum. That's what I would have did, personally. Because that's how I get down. I'm a lady. I'm a gangster, but I'm a lady. All right? So don't get it twisted. There's certain things we just not going to do. Now, don't get it twisted. People in these streets can get this work. But I'm a lady most of the time. I don't be having no drama in my life for real. Well, I've had some in the last few months, but that's that it. No drama. So let me put this on the screen. Let's see if we can hear what she says to him as well. Because it's crazy. Let's see. Can we hear this? Let me see. Well, anyway. Oh, okay. Wait. We can hear it. Hold on, y'all. I got y'all. I just want to.
You don't remember kicking your vibe or something?
You know, you ever heard that old
thing
people know who to play with?
So he said, she said, you don't ever think
money in your pocket.
Yeah.
Real money?
Okay. Just hours before the armed robbery, surveillance video shows rapper Bankroll Freddy, whose real name is Freddy Gladney III, joking with a front desk employee.
You
know, you ever heard
that old thing, people know who to play with?
Is that
money in your pocket?
Yeah. It's real money?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just hours before the
arm. All right, so let me turn my mic back up and remove this really quickly. So, as you can see, he had just had the conversation with the clerk at the desk. Y'all gotta stop thinking that y'all invincible out here and like can't nothing happen to you. Something can happen to you. Like Boo said, crooked cops, bad apples, streets ain't safe. They never were. I'm working on a piece right now. So if you're my friend on Facebook, on my actual Facebook page and not the podcast page, you will see me posting things on there because they're going to play a part in what I'm working on right now. A piece that I'm working on right now. But he says, he was about to say, I want those listen, you gotta stop thinking. He said, you ever heard, like, some people, no, sir, everybody out here can get played with. Everybody, some people ain't to be, but everybody, including you, and obviously you found out. Because they robbed you and they took your money. You can't be walking around with wads of money in your pocket. That old lady said, ooh, what if she was part of it? I'm just saying. What if she made the phone call like, this dude got all the money in his pocket. And then that's why they showed up and that's how they knew. What if I ain't one of those? Now, listen. Niggas be out here. I'm sorry. Excuse my language. People be out here catching people lacking, and everybody think that they can't get got, but they can, because this is that, take that one chance opportunity where you lacking and they got you. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a wild world out here. We really living in the wild, wild west right now, and it's crazy. She wouldn't have said that. I don't know. She just gave her. No, I don't know. Because, see, people, maybe, but just hear me out. People, and we'll be out on time because I got to cut some people off in a minute. People fall for that little old lady act, right? Oh, she's so sweet. She an old lady. What if that was her grandson? You don't know. You don't know. I'm just saying, you just don't know. What does she call it? Like, not him, not the cop per se, but what if it was like one of the robbers was her grandson and she bought that life? You know, they be bought that life in Atlanta. So she bought that life and she like, son, this nigga up here with a pocket full of money. Yeah, he would never think I did it. I'm a sweet old lady. I'm just saying. It's not too deep. Look, we in Baltimore. Shit happens. It's not too deep. All kinds of shit be happening. I'm just saying. I'm going to leave it alone, but I'm just saying. I'm just saying. All right, so let me say this before I move on to my... No. I'm going to give y'all a couple of minutes before I cut this short, because I want to talk about this. I've been concerned about this young man for a minute now. And so I want to get into his story. Should I be nice and not cut it short tonight and then cut it short on Wednesday? Because I'm going to be back Wednesday. This Wednesday I'm actually running and don't have as much. Yeah, I've been very concerned about this young man. Should I cut it short? What should I do? Should I let y'all rock and then cut it short for everybody else, for the listener? I don't know. I think I should keep going and then figure out from there where I'm going to go. But I've been very concerned about this young man lately. I was concerned about him a while back, but I'm really concerned about him now. So let me... I know, but sometimes I'll be getting wrapped up in these stories and then I don't want to cut it short, but I kind of have to. Listen, we got to do something. y'all want me to stop cutting these shows short, y'all got to send some donations. You feel me? Because otherwise, I got to charge. But, you know, whatever. Tonight, I'm a rock out because I'm very concerned for this young man. I have been very concerned for this young man for a long time. But anyway, so first, we have the situation where he gets online with the person he accused of doing him harm in the first place. I'm not going to say his name because he be getting people. Yeah, and I don't have time for that. But anyway, then he retracts his statement and he says that's not what really happened, but his brother, Ricky Romax, is the person responsible for doing those horrible, horrific things to him. And he just said, cuzzo, because, you know, that's what was fed into his head. Okay, so whatever. I already knew he was dealing with some issues in the beginning, but when that happened, I'm just like, hold up, wait, what? Because he was adamant about it for years. He's been very adamant about this story, about his cousin and Marcus Houston doing things to him and all of this kind of stuff. And then he said they did things to Fizz and they did things to Jay Boog and all of that. Yeah. But you don't like my conspiracy theory, so I'm not going to go there. But anyway, let's just get to the story. So, because I got a theory on that one too. I do. But so he breaks a window, Raz B, that is from B2K, breaks a window and gets on the hospital roof. His brother voices scream concern. So listen, Raz B's brother says their family is concerned about his behavior and they're asking for prayers. I'm not going to play his video. I have my feelings about Ricky Romance, but whatever. So Ricardo Thornton posted a video on social media addressing Rasby's hospital incident, saying that their mom is working with the hospital staff to make sure Raz is safe as he undergoes surgery. Alarming behavior from Rasby, breaking a window at the hospital and climbing onto the building roof, forcing police to get involved. It was crazy. The scary incident went down last Thursday in Kansas City, the morning after the B2K singer posted a video on Instagram where he repeatedly said that he did not feel safe. Raz B claims to be at a Hilton hotel in Kansas City on Wednesday night, that was last Wednesday, saying that he was fighting to stay alive and he didn't want to have this surgery here, which is at the hospital where the incident took place. He also posted the address for the Kansas City hospital. There's a video showing him on the roof of the same hospital as shock onlookers watched in horror from the window across the way. Law enforcement says officers were dispatched to St. Luke's Hospital at 10:20 a.m. last Thursday, after being called by off-duty cops and hospital security. The police say when they got there, they determined that he had broken a window in order to climb onto the roof. There was concern Raz might jump off of the ledge. Cops say that the fire department responded to the scene and place mats down below just in case he did. The police say that a negotiator got involved too, and he ultimately came back through the window peacefully and was treated by medical staff. His behavior. Okay, so let's get to some of these comments really quick. So yeah, he does. Yes, he does need help. Very much. Plus he is probably got to do shows because money might be tight. Yeah, that's why he's on that Bad Boys show that they got on Zeus. That plays a major part of it. That can't put him over the edge. He ain't Spider. See this? Oh, come on. I'm trying to be serious. Stop. All right. So, listen. My prayers go out to him. I hope that he gets the help that he needs. I've been very concerned about this young man for a minute now. But this situation right here, and I didn't talk about it right away because I wanted some more intel about what was going on. But I'm going to be honest with you. That's a scary, scary thing. And just the thought that he stated it before he even got there that he didn't feel safe. So the fact that he started saying that should have been an alarm for everybody around him. Like, real talk. That should have been like a major alarm for everybody around him. Like, hold up, what? So let's get into some politics really quickly. Because I have to, you know, I have to juggle it around. Sometimes I can't always just be talking about these celebrity fools. Even though I guess technically the politicians are celebrity fools too. But whatever. So President Biden, on that deadline, we have a deal. Now it's Congress' turn. You know how this goes within the government. They go back and forth. Yeah, politics and bullshit. You know what I mean? Politics and bullshit. I'm going to leave that on the screen for a second. Politics and bullshit. Because, like, listen, we are all adults, the people that watch my show. And part of being adults is knowing what's going on in the world of this world of ours, especially in politics. It's very, very important. But listen, so President Biden says a deal has been reached with the GOP on a bill to raise the U.S. The U.S.'s debt ceiling, but Congress still has to sign off on it, and pretty soon too. Biden made an announcement the Sunday that just passed, telling reporters he and Speaker Kevin McCarthy finalized the language of legislation they'll introduce to the House of Representatives later this week, in hopes that it passes quickly, at which point it goes to the Senate. Now, I got some things to say about this. Give me 1 second. I'm going to get to it in a second, but what time is it? While it remains to be seen if that all actually happened, it needs to before June or out. Joe sounded optimistic about the bipartisan agreement, noting both sides didn't necessarily get everything they wanted, but in the same breath, admitting that what they landed on was good enough to avoid a catastrophic default, likely economic collapse. Bullshit, Joe. Bullshit. I'm sorry. I'm not even going to go all the way into it. We grown. Yeah, we grown. We talking about it. Thank you, baby. See, you on point. You know what it is. But bullshit. I call bullshit. Let me tell you why. No, everybody didn't get. But I don't think people understand what raising the debt ceiling entails. Yeah, it helps them a little bit as far as the government is concerned, but it doesn't help us as a people. A lot more unemployment. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, prices are skyrocketing. Yeah. It's going to be hard for us, some of us anyway. So don't get it twisted. They talk a good talk, but they don't always walk a good walk. So we're going to see what happens with this situation. It drives me insane, these people. People drive me insane. They do. I don't know. Oh, no. Is it still frozen? Okay, thank you. You scared me. I'm like, what? Oh, no. Okay. Oh, no. I don't want it to freeze. I got some more shit to say. I got some shit to talk, and especially about our government. I got some things to say about our government. They drive me insane. I don't, like, really do. And I'll be trying not to talk about it too much about how crazy they drive me because I don't want to push y'all away. But they know what they're doing. They know exactly what they're doing. And it's never for the benefit of us. They say it is. They say they represent us. They say, you know, but these things aren't set up for us. They're set up for... because if it's really set up for the country, then why do we have debt in other countries? Like, I get it. Everybody borrows money from each other. Everybody. I don't care. Like, everybody. I don't care what country you are. It's a country that borrowed money from another country in order for them to sustain and, you know, be operating and not a third world country. But in my mind, is it really for us or is it really for them to do all their underhanded bullshit? We're going to touch down more on this politics thing, but it just drives me insane. I'm sorry. I wanted to talk a little bit about politics today, though. It was in my mind to talk a little bit about this politics thing. I don't want to stay on it too long, but it's a little in my head. Let's move on. Let's get to this story right here. So, the person who allegedly took off. I hate that I just said that like that. But the person who allegedly took out Takeoff was indicted for taking him out. Because I hate saying that N-word. It's just annoying. But Carl Moore, says that today's action by the grand jury is not unexpected. We would ask people to remember that getting an indictment requires meeting a very, very minimal standard of proof. When we get inside the courtroom and in front of the jury, where we will be able to put on our evidence and cross examinations, the state's witness, where the standard of proof of is guilt beyond a reasonable doubt, we expect the jury will come back with a verdict of not guilty. As we all know, the unfortunate situation with Takeoff happened in Texas. Let's just get into it. Takeoff's alleged person of interest, Patrick Xavier Clark, has been formally charged with his, you know, demise in the Migos rapper's shooting. Oh my gosh, there's so much sadness. I can't even get past saying the words, but his demise. Okay. A Texas grand jury indicted Clark on his passing. On Thursday, the Harris County District Attorney Office told KHOU. The footage, see, this is the thing. Okay, I'll get to that in a minute. There's footage, of course. There's footage. Hold on. There's footage. But I still don't see where. Hold on. So at it's a business and a system. It is absolutely bars. no bars. Put forth the evidence to reach a standard of proof. Exactly. That's what they have to do. That's how it usually goes. Although I'm not going with my conspiracy theories today. not now. But. Deep breath. I know. Sad a young black man's passing. I know, because it's ridiculous at this point. I need all of y'all to sit the fuck down and stop doing stuff to each other. Our race in general, I don't know how much longer we're going to make it. But here's the thing. There's footage of that incident, but because there is footage of that incident nowhere, and I've seen the footage, I'm quite sure you have too, I have not seen in the footage where you can identify, unless they got some deep witnesses that we don't know about, which I haven't heard. I've heard what happened, but I haven't heard a witness actually say, identify him and say he's the one who did it. So I don't know how this case is going to go, but you know how the justice system, and now we talking about Texas, and I got family in Texas. I wish they tap in from time to time and talk about it. But in Texas, we talking about Texas. And in Texas, in the South period, and then in general, in the South period, it's different. It's different. It's way different. So I don't know. I don't know how that's going to pan out. Are they going to find him guilty? Are they going to find him not guilty? But, you know, you have to prove without a shadow of a doubt that he actually did it. And I haven't heard any witnesses come forth yet to say that he actually did it. Not once. Well, let me see. Well, Jay Prince supposed to run his city. That's what they say. That's what I heard. But I don't think Jay Prince really give a shit about this dude. It's like, in my opinion, as long as it's not Jay Prince going down for it, Jay Prince don't care about that dude and whether or not that dude goes down for it. Let me see. So if he really bout it, he will do the right thing. But I love when you be in the building. I do. But we talk about Jay Prince. Jay Prince. What about Jay Prince says that he's going to do the right thing ever? What about anybody in the industry? Period. Now I can come back in with my expertise. What about anybody in the industry says that they're going to do the right thing? Especially Jay Prince. I hope he got his grandkid because his daughter was wilding. But what about Jay Prince says he's going to do the right thing? I don't think anything about Jay Prince. His character don't even tell me he going to do the right thing. Like, you ever listen to him doing interviews? You ever listen to him, like, when he goes live? Nothing about Jay Prince says that he's going to do the right thing. Nothing. Nothing thus far has told me that Jay Prince is going to do the right thing. Ever. Sorry, ever. Never. Anyway, so that's the tea that I had to spill for the day. I thought I had some quick ones that I wanted to talk about. Some quick ones. What about Jay Prince say he gonna do the right thing? Nothing. I'm sorry. Turnover. The perpetrators are sitting in the hill. Well, if that was the case, he would have did that when it happened. Nope. Nothing. His son was there. Yeah, his son was there. And you know he ain't giving him up. His son was absolutely there. And hunting. Before he give up his own seedlings, he'll let the next man take blame for it. And that's that. I just don't see it. I don't. Quick topics real quick before I get to showing some love. Target, of course, they're in trouble. They lose $9 billion in a week following the boycott calls over the LGBTQ friendly kids clothing. How I feel about that? Listen, to each his own. How you want to raise your child is how you want to raise your child. I say just don't put it in their face. Like, don't push the narrative. Don't do that. Like, y'all deal with y'all situation at home, but it shouldn't be where it's a situation where it's in the stores where you got. Look at this shit. Hold on. I got to put this on the screen now, y'all. I got to. Because I want you to understand why this is such a big deal right now. For those who don't get it. I'm going to put this on the screen. For those who do not get it. And like I said, I don't care what you do with your private life. But I don't want, when me and my kid walk into Target, a narrative being pushed. Now look at this. These, hold on, let me see if I can make this bigger on the screen. Let's see how big I can make it. Okay, I can't get it, but so big. This, if you see on the screen, they were selling bathing suits that catered to tucking. That's crazy. This should be, no, I'm gonna get this off my screen. There should be no reason why that narrative should ever be pushed on. Hey, what's up, P Money? But there should be no reason why ever that narrative should be pushed on anybody's child. I don't care who it is. And yes, I could see how Target lost money because there are still a lot of people out here who are not ready for that kind. Again, I don't feel no kind of way about anybody living their life the way they want to live their life, not even your children. But I do feel some kind of way about that narrative being pushed on other children. You feel me? Like, that should not be something like, okay, if your son or daughter is trans, even at an early age, then take them in the girl section, buy them girl clothes. But there should not be a section where it just catered to that. Because the whole thing of them being trans is that they feel like they are girls or women or men or boys in the inside. So then you take them in the... You never saw this story? What? What? Well, I'm glad I can enlighten you. Yes. Target lost $9 billion in a week because they decided that they wanted to sell clothes that you know, catered to... And it's not just the bathing suits with the tuck, you know, situation in it. It's also that they just had everything, flags, all of that stuff. They had a nice big sign. There was a man who went through there who tore down one of the signs, started kicking it. Because it's like, you have to allow, especially, and this is not for teenagers. This is not for adults. This is for children. Little children. You have to allow the parents and the child to work through that situation first. You can't push the narrative. You as a corporation should be ashamed of yourself for pushing the narrative. Let them figure it out first before you start putting it all in their faces. That's all I'm saying. It's nothing about anybody being what they are, because you are what you are, but just don't push the narrative in people's faces. Like, y'all out of pocket for this shit now, and it's getting annoying. It's really getting annoying. If my daughter decides that she doesn't like boys and she likes girls, or if my daughter decides that she wants to be trans, first and foremost, I'm going to support my daughter in everything that she decides. But what you're not going to do is push the narrative in her face. That's what you're not going to do. So yeah, babe, that's what happened. That's what happened. Let her figure it out first. You don't figure it out for her. Let her figure it out. Let me figure it out. Let us figure it out. And then we'll go from there. We don't need you to have a whole section of clothes for us to figure it out. Like, let us figure it out. Let us, as the parents, do our job. We don't need you to make decisions for us or for our children in stores at all. It bothers me. But anyway, I gotta show some love. I'm gonna show some love. I'm just Target. Oh, well, yeah, let me show this love and then I'll get to the other stuff. But Target, cut it out. Anyway, my top six: the United States, France, Germany, India, the UK, let's see, United States, France, Germany, India, the UK. Who am I missing? They made me upset. Belgium. They got me upset just now. United States, France, Germany, India, the UK, Belgium. Okay, there we go. All of them in the thing made me mad, man. It's not show notes, it's love. We're gonna stop calling it show notes. Okay, but I love you all the same. They just my top six in my listening audience, and I always show them love first. Shout out to anybody watching from Twitch. Boo. And anybody watching from YouTube, I appreciate you as well. But they not show notes. This is love. That's what we call it over here. Love. Anyway, so Brazil, I love you. Netherlands, I love you. Singapore, I love you. Spain, I love you. Philippines, I love you. Australia, I love you. Japan, I love you. Mexico, I love you. Ireland, I love you. Nepal, I love you. Mauritius, I love you. Israel, I love you. Canada, I love you. Hong Kong, hey, I love you. Hey, I'm not done. I'm not finished. That was just one. Boo gonna be talking about my notes. I mean, my love. Soon, because they're gonna get raggedy because I keep throwing them. Russia, I love you. China, I love you. I'm still in amazement. Yes, I think I said the Netherlands already. Poland, I love you. Tunisia, I love you. Venezuela, baby, I love you. Hi, honeys. I love you. 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 I do. Oh, my gosh, I do. I want to make sure I don't miss anybody. Okay, Indonesia, I love you, darlings. New Zealand, I love you. Switzerland, I love you. Turkey, I see y'all coming back. I love you. Hey. Austria, I love you. Kenya, I love you. Pakistan, I love you. Romania, I love you. South Africa, hi, babies. I love you. And Nigeria, I see you too. I see y'all coming through and showing me love. And see, no, they're not showing up that they love. Shut up. Anyway, yeah. Russia, Indonesia, and no, I don't know they show notes. I know that that's love, okay? That's love, anyway. So, whatever. Some things happening tomorrow, though. I need y'all to know about them real quick. You know, been working hard over here and getting things in order. But tomorrow night, we will be back live again for the tap-in. Yeah, we got King Knox. We're going to talk about it. So let me explain the tap-in. The tap-in is where we sit down and we analyze music, mainly hip-hop, but music in general, that we've grown up on, we've loved, we've come accustomed to, we just adore it. You get on my nerves. No, it's just love. But anyway, so yeah, we got some things going on tomorrow night. Leave me alone so I can tell y'all what's going on. Anyway, so we got some things going on tomorrow night to tap in, where we're going to discuss some things. We don't know what exact music we are going to discuss, what song, because it's basically broken down with by artists, albums, or singles, and it's in a bag. We ruffle the bag up, then we pick one, and then we have a discussion about it. So we don't know just yet what we're talking about just yet, but just know that that's going down tomorrow night. Again, the name of this show is called The Tap-In, and we got a guest co-host, King Knox. He's very inclined to hip-hop. Who is sending me messages? Okay. In the middle of my shop. Anyway, but he that's what he does. It's also my artist of mine, but we're gonna talk about it. We're gonna break it down and we're gonna get into some stuff, and so that'll be happening tomorrow night at 9:30. Same place. So that's going down, and it is what it is. What else is happening? So the tapping is finally coming to fruition. I'm forgetting some things, but yeah, it's a random pick situation. It's a random pick situation, and we just both going to give our expert opinions about how we felt. That, you know, it, like, it could be, let's see, who, like, what could come out of there? Snoop Dogg, you feel me? But then we both sit down and we talk about Snoop Dogg and where we were at, what kind of things went down. So it's gonna be a hoop, but that's going down tomorrow night. Again, we got a new fire mix coming on Friday night as well. So now it's four shows instead of, I told you I was over here. That's why I've been missing these Wednesdays. I'm not missing this Wednesday because I got a lot to say on Wednesday as well. That's the titillating conversation. I am a hip hop head, so I will try to be there. Please do, babes. And if you can't be there, catch the playback. You feel me? But we gonna talk about it. It should be fun because I myself as well am a hip hop head as well. So I think everybody will find anybody that loves hip hop, and we'll switch it up every now and again, and maybe do perhaps some R&B. I like to throw them in there too. You feel me? Because I love R&B music as well. But we're gonna, I'm sorry, y'all, I gotta put my hand in the ponytail. I'm hot. I'm getting hot in here. Break out the fan. But yeah, I think everybody will gain something from it. So just make sure you tune in, and it should be fun. Oh yeah, happy Memorial. I forgot. You know what? I've been forgetting all day that the day was Memorial Day. I've been talking trash about my neighbor. He worked for BG&E, and I'm like, he's never home. His van is never parked there, but the day is parked there. And I was like, oh, we off today? But then I thought about it, like, oh, it's Memorial Day. Then I went upstairs, and like, oh shit, we didn't check the mail. I forgot it's Memorial Day. But happy Memorial Day, everybody. I totally forgot. And my kid been home all day, so I should not have forgotten that it was Memorial Day, but I did. But anyway, let's get to the thing. Let me just say, if you would like to come on this show, hit me up, ambitiouslythepodcast@gmail.com, ambitiouslythepodcast@gmail.com. The phone line is always open. You can always drop, like my boo here, you can always drop a comment, or you can call in, or you can ask me to drop the link and I will, and you can come on camera too with me and we can have a conversation. It's up to you, boo. If I play music, know that I have permission always to play the music. I do. And if you're looking for us on social media, IG at Miss_ambitiouslyent, on Facebook at ambitiously, on YouTube at ambitiously the podcast. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Every like, every share, and every subscription is greatly appreciated. We love you for that. Thank you. Check out the website, www.ambitiouslyentertainment.com, www.ambitiouslyentertainment.com. It is under construction. Excuse the mess. If you would like to donate so I can stop cutting the show in half, then donations can be Cash App, $ Lord Lucidity, capital LURLUCIDITY, to lure them in clearly. Lucidity. There you go. So you know. And the podcast is streaming on every streaming platform. I don't care where you go, iHeartRadio, Google Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, Amazon Music, Samsung, wherever you want it, baby, we there. Let me see what Boo talk about. No, I didn't drop it. You know why? But I'm going to drop it in a minute. I didn't drop it because I didn't cut the show in half because I was having fun talking to you, Boo. Wait. But since you brought it up, so I don't have to say it. Sorry to say it. Yeah. Since you started shit, don't start no shit. Don't be no shit. I'm going to play it right now. Since you started it, I'm going to finish it. Here you go. Want more of Ambitiously the Podcast? Then make sure that you subscribe. We are on Patreon, View It, Red Circle, Acast, and Station Head. Let's go. Yeah, I didn't have to say it. Aunt Cat, she worldwide, Craig, whatever. Top, I'm gonna run with that forever now. Now I'm top flight security. I am, you know what I mean? But anyway, yeah, so there's some things happening around here, though, and we everywhere, so make sure you tune in without a doubt. Here's my DJ's information if you want. You know, holler at him. You know, he's a dope ass DJ. We should have a new mix this Friday as well. So be ready for that, babes. Be ready for that. What time is it? Oh, I'm over my time. So let me say this, because there's some things that a girl has to say before she get up out of here. I'm going to leave top fight security on the screen while I say it. First things first, mind your business. Everybody's business is not your business. But you come here like on today, Media Monday, and I'll tell you other people's business because that's what I like to do on Media Mondays. I like to tell everybody's business. If it's a business to be told, baby, I'm telling it. But in these streets, mind your business because it's dangerous out here and you can't get away with being nosy all the time. So just mind your business. And I'm going to tell you the difference between minding your business and standing in your life. Hug your babies. Tell your babies that. Oh, let's bring this down. That they are the goat. I don't know if it, yep, the goat. Y'all can see that. Tell your babies that they are that. You feel me? They need that encouragement. They need you to tell them that, because who else is going to tell them? You know, sometimes these punk ass teachers don't tell them shit, but tell them they to go. They need that love. They want to work for NASCAR, then tell them to be the best pit boss, NASCAR driver, commentator, or whatever the hell else they do over there at NASCAR. I don't know. I don't work for NASCAR. If they want to work for NASA, then tell them to be the best astronaut, engineer, janitor, receptionist, secretary, or whatever the hell else they do over there at NASA. I don't know. Never worked there either. But encourage them to be great at whatever it is that they're going to do, because they need that encouragement, because nobody else is going to do it. Stay in your lane, because everybody's lane is not your lane. You jump in my lane, you already. You already. You already. Like, you jump in my lane, you getting her. You don't want her. You want her. She cute, cuddly, and all that good stuff. She is. Or at least her. Because, baby, if I'm purring, I'm a happy, happy girl. Nothing like me purring. But you jump in my lane, you're going to get that first one, and you don't want her. Plus, what usually happens when you jump in other people's lanes is a collision. And who the hell needs that? Nobody. Nobody needs a collision. So just stay in your lane. And there is a difference between jumping in other people's lanes and being nosy. See, from afar, you could be nosy. What's going on? Let me see what's happening. But when you jump in people's lanes, that means you're inserting yourself into something that you have no business inserting yourself into. So why do it? Just staying. That's it. And last but not least, what? Wait, before I get out of here, because speaking of teachers, you see the video when they didn't acknowledge the little black girl at the promote. Listen, I wish they would not acknowledge my baby. She already know what time it is, though. I wish they would. But anyway, last but not least, choose your battles wisely. Every battle is not your battle to fight. It's not. Some battles you just gotta let it go. You feel me? Let it go, because it's a war out here and we fighting it every day. So worry about the war and not so much the battles. Choose your battles wisely. Now, some battles you can fight, but just choose them wisely. Every battle is not yours to fight, all right? I got to get out of here, though, y'all. I love the vibe. I love the energy. Boo always coming through, showing love, and I appreciate you for that, babes. Thank you. Thank you so much. But I got to get out of here. It's a lot coming up, so just bear with me. It's, girl, just here, there, somewhere, everywhere. And like I told you, I'm back in my management and marketing bag, so that's a whole nother lane. But yeah, I got y'all. Tune in tomorrow night. The tapping. It's going to be deep. Good night, babe. Wait. I ain't going nowhere until I be like the Brazilian man at the pageant. No, don't be like him. He already done caused enough havoc. No, I'm getting out of here, because I ain't messing with you. You about to have people going to prison. Bye. Good night, y'all. I love y'all.